hasn't met anyone as yet who can really, really test him.
Okay, well, certainly the most dangerous fighter, Jamie McDonald's accomplished career. Let's hear his thoughts on the challenge ahead.
This is the fight I want. This is going to be everything, you know. I could really, like, kind of make a bit of a legacy for myself. I'll beat this kid, you know. I'll be the kid who travels and wins. You know, not many go out, you know, and win abroad, especially against pound for pound. Hopefully, the hope is going to be a great, you know what I mean? So that's what's got me motivated, and that's what's making me train as hard and dig in like I am, because I want it that bad. He can bang, he's fast. He's got it all. As long as I get in there and do what I need to do, I can beat him and I can make it look easy. I think his reputation as the monster and coming out, you know, trying to blast you out, scares a lot of people. But it doesn't scare me, you know. I've been in there, I've seen it, I've done it. It takes a good champion, a great champion, to be able to stay switched on under that pressure and under being caught and dazed, to keep doing what you need to do. And I believe I've been there. Hopefully, you know, all this hard work, what I'm doing here, will pay off on the night, and I stick to what I need to do and get a good win. This is a fight I can prove myself to the very, very highest level, you know what I mean? And that's what I want. It's nothing to do with money, paydays or anything, this fight. This is for me to prove I am the best bantamweight on this planet.
Interesting, isn't it? Jamie talking about he needs to prove himself. If you look at his record, he's been undefeated for 10 years. Four of those years he's been world champion, but he's kind of gone a little bit under the radar, hasn't he? How much do you think he needs to win this fight to prove himself?
Well, I think he's already secured his legacy as someone that travels and goes into the opponent's backyard and gets the win, gets the job done. Fears no one. Oh, I love his attitude, you know, a real throwback. Go anywhere, fight anyone. And I don't think he'll give too much respect to anyone. I think he believes in himself, but it's just the timing of the fight. You know, 32 years old, and he's struggling at the weight. He looked really drawn there facially. Online they're saying he's putting on 26 pounds. To be able to put 26 pounds, I mean, he must be massively dehydrated at the weight to do that. But you know what? I think he's already secured his legacy. Big entourage there, but you know, he's obviously quickly becoming a superstar over there. You know, they've obviously put a lot of money up to get the world title fight over in Japan, to get home advantage, and you know, 15-0, 30 knockouts. I think he's a bit of a special talent.
It's not been an easy week in the McDonald camp, really. Dave Caldwell, of course, his son very sadly has been in hospital with meningitis, and as we mentioned there at the top of the show, the passing of Brendan England as well. Both Dave and Richard Towers very close to him. Not been easy, but his business, and it does go on.
Yes, it does. It's going to be a tremendously hard week. We don't know what's been going on behind the scenes in Tokyo. I mean, they're saying all the right things. We don't know how hard it is out there in Tokyo. The humidity in Tokyo as well. And everything's going on behind the scenes. But what I will say about David Caldwell is, you know, he hasn't performed so well, he hasn't been as active, 32, struggling to make the weight, looked very drawn there at the weigh-in, and I just think he's up against a really special fighter.
Let's talk tactics then. What does Jamie need to do?
You know, he has to deter. You know, he can't have him, you know, coming forward, piling on so much pressure, you know, working him up. He goes to the body so well, but it's educated aggression, it's off the jab. He looks like the real deal. You know, he's a not just a big heavy puncher, he was a top class amateur, very good fighter, everything behind the jab, great hand speed. You know, he's got to try and take the player away from him, try and back him up. I think if he backs off him, I think he's just going to invite more pressure.
Well, these are live pictures now. There is Inoue preparing to walk to the ring. Let us remind ourselves, he's 25 years old. This is just his 16th professional fight. He's already a two-weight world champion. We know he has that incredible power. What are you expecting to see from him?
I think we're going to see an exceptionally fast start. This is what's going to be crucial for McDonald to survive those first few rounds. Inoue, he throws astonishing punches. The left hook in particular is a great one, particularly to the body. He's got a leaping right hand, which is almost like Gennady Golovkin, watching that. And it's what McDonald will need to do. His jab has got to be better than it's ever been before. It's got to be a piston jab. And at some point, he's going to have to take a chance when the pressure is swirling away. You know, and the scary thing is as well, it goes to the body so well, and you've been struggling to make weight, and you're not going to really absorb the body shots so well.
Very good prediction, Matt.
I'd love to see Jamie McDonald do it, but I have to go with Inoue.
Southern Matt?
Yeah, I think I favour Inoue probably to win inside this.
Okay, well, let's find out and let's get straight to it then. Jamie McDonald takes on the monster. Here is Spencer and Andy Clark.
Bang Sandoval, as you mentioned, in his 16th professional fight, looking to land the world title in a third separate weight division. WBO light flyweight champion in his sixth fight. WBO super flyweight champion in his eighth, after a brutal destruction of long reigning champ Omar Narvaez. We know about the power, we know about the ability. Everybody's been talking about this fight, Spencer, in terms of what a big ask it is for Jamie McDonald. But let's just turn it around for a second. There's a lot of pressure on him tonight.
Yeah, it certainly is. I mean, McDonald, listen, he comes with a wealth of experience. He boxes away from home really well as well. They're up for this challenge. And Nui, you know, he's not boxed at the level that Jamie McDonald has. So it's a big ask for him as well. This is a tough fight for Nui.
His team manager.
Looks like the real deal. You know, he's not just a big, heavy puncher. He was a top-class amateur. Very good fighter. Everything behind the jab. Great hand speed. You know, he's got to try and take the player away from him, try and back him up. I think if he backs off him, I think he's just going to be a lot more pressure.
Well, these are live pictures now. There is Inoue preparing to walk to the ring. Let's just remind ourselves, 25 years old. This is just his 16th professional fight. He's already a two-weight world champion. We know he has that incredible power. What are you expecting to see from him?
I think we're going to see an exceptionally fast start. This is what's going to be crucial for McDonald to survive those first few rounds. Inoue, he throws astonishing punches. The left hook in particular is a great one, particularly to the body. He's got a looping right hand, which is almost like an RDB off kick, watching that. And what we're going to need to do. His jab has got to be better than it's ever been before. It's got to be a piston jab. And at some point, he's going to have to take a chance when the pressure is swirling away.
You know, the scare goes the body so well, and you've been struggling to make way, and you're not going to really absorb the body shot so well.
Very good prediction, Matt.
I'd love to see Jamie McDonald do it, but I have to go with Inoue.
Talk to Matt.
Yeah, I think I favour Inoue probably to win this.
Okay, well, let's find out. So let's get straight to it then. Jamie McDonald takes on the monster. Here is Spencer and Andy Clark.
Bang Sandoval, as you mentioned, in his 16th professional fight, looking to land the world title in a third separate weight division. WBO light flyweight champion in his sixth fight. WBO super flyweight champion in his eighth, after a brutal destruction of long reigning champ Omar Narvaez. We know about the power, we know about the ability. Everybody's been talking about this fight, Spencer, in terms of what a big ask it is for Jamie McDonald. But let's just turn it around for a second. There's a lot of pressure on him tonight.
Yeah, it certainly is. I mean, McDonald, listen, he comes with a wealth of experience. He boxes away from home really well as well. They're up for this challenge. And Nui, you know, he's not boxed at the level that Jamie McDonald has. So it's a big ask for him as well. This is a tough fight for Nui.
His team managing to get him home advantage for this. Boxing flourishing as it always has in the lower weight divisions in Japan. The rise of Noah Inoue has been meteoric off the back of a decent amateur career, but Jamie McDonald there looking substantially different to how he did on the scales yesterday. And they fancy this job. They have done right from the very start, himself and Dave Caldwell and brother Gavin in the background there. A couple of weeks in Dubai alongside Anthony Fowler and Jordan Gill too, then over to Japan. 10 years he has stayed unbeaten. British, Commonwealth, European titles, IBF and WBA world titles. He's gone away from home and done the business against Arnaud, against Kameda twice when he was taken over there to lose. That was the plan for the promoters. In Hidalgo, Texas, the first time around, and then again in Corpus Christi. But he hadn't read the script, and he's not reading it tonight. If he can do this, Spencer, this will go down in the pantheon of great British away wins, alongside Roy Hannigan, Kirkland Lang, John H. Strachan, Ken Buchanan, Kell Brook, and Tyson Fury in more recent times.
Yeah, definitely. In a way, he's fast emerging as one of the best pound-for-pound fighters in in the world at the moment, and this is a big ask for McDonald, but you know, he is used to fighting away from home. He's spent a career on upsetting the odds, and he's going to try and do it again here this evening.
Nui being made to wait. McDonald now in the ring, looks a little tense, a little nervous, but there's nothing wrong with that.
ここで本土のバンタム級世界タイトルマッチに駆けつけていただいた我が国が誇るバンタム級のレジェンド歴代王者をご紹介いたします。まずは世界は63戦56勝7敗、56勝のうち23勝が残ることブラジルの伝説エデル・ジョフレから1965年にその王座を奪い、また当時の世界戦中継は全て50%以上を記録するなど、
the humidity got him up to five or six rounds. It is a different environment. Crowd. So final instructions from Luis Pabon, and we are ready. The opening stage is going to be absolutely critical here. We expect Inoue to come out quick, to come out firing. Matt touched on it in the studio, that jab of McDonald, the height advantage, the reach advantage that comes with it. That jab has got to be a snappy, piercing jab. He's got to be able to try and keep Inoue off him.
Yeah, he really has got to utilize all the skills, all the attributes that he's got. Jamie McDonald, he needs to keep this long. He needs to work everything off the jab. Nice movement from side to side. Keep that head moving. We know Inoue is going to look to get on the inside. Really does double up well to the hooks, to the head and the body. Inoue wax will by the hand. So this is the tactics that we need to see from McDonald. Just keeping it long.
Looking for that right hand, looking for the left of the body as well early on. That's a danger shot. Inoue, McDonald just taking away back into the ropes there, just dropping those elbows on that left hand.
Yeah, I think McDonald may have felt the weight of a couple of those body shots there. Inoue rushed in, didn't he? And really switched those attacks downstairs, and I think McDonald felt that.
Stepped up from super flyweight anyway. Just couldn't make that wait any longer. He wouldn't have left that division unless he absolutely had to, given all the heat and the buzz that there is. Wild at the moment, heavy left hand seemed to catch McDonald high on the head, almost on the top of the head there, and his legs seem a little bit shaky here. A minute and a half into the first round, and McDonald goes over from the left hand to the body. Inoue raises a fist in salute to the crowd at ringside. McDonald was in his own corner there, in that red corner. Dave McDonald communicating with him. He's got to get through this opening round. He's got a minute left. Retreats to the ropes immediately. Inoue looking to tee off with that right hand, left hand, and McDonald sucks into the ropes again. And Luis Pabon, the referee, has jumped in and waved this off inside the first round. Jamie McDonald has been blown away by Noah Inoue. He's been slain by the monster. And that was exactly what we were hoping that we wouldn't see. But that left hand high on the head got him going. And then with just over a minute left, Spencer, you feared the worst.
Yeah, caught cold, wasn't he? And that's what we did fear. Inoue, we knew was going to start fast. He'd come flying out, started switching the hooks to the body and the head. The first hook that landed